Hi, today we're going to look at four ways to update the data in your Excel dashboards using Anatella, going from a poor setup, but sadly the most used, to the best practice. As an extra, I will show you how to schedule your flow on a daily basis. We have four flows to show, but let me first show you the demo dashboard we will be using for this video. We have a very simple dashboard that gives the sales per country and per year. The data itself is stored in a separate datasheet. And to keep up with good practices, we'll be using a named range in Excel to reference the data. Let's start with the first flow, to update your data in Excel. This is the approach that is used the most. However, it's not the one we recommend, as a lot can go wrong during use of your Excel file or during the update. And if something's going wrong, you don't only lose your data, but also your dashboard. So the flow we see here reads and cleans the data, calculates the KPI, and updates the data in the Excel sheet. When we zoom in on the Excel box, we see the mode Update Existing File and Change an Existing Sheet is selected. Anatella will open the file, update the data, and overwrite the file with a new version. Functional, it works. But if something goes wrong, the data and the report is lost, which is kind of a dangerous setup, a setup to avoid. Now, let's go for the first improvement, separating the report template and your data. If we look at the new file structure, we can see we have a separate directory for templates and a published directory. The Anatella flow looks almost exactly the same. We only changed the write mode in the Excel box. Copy and update the duplicate by changing an existing sheet. This mode now will read the template Excel file and create a copy while updating the data and save it to the published directory. Now, we need to provide the template Excel file, which is actually just a copy of your report in the template directory, and provide the destination of the published report. Of course, the idea is to secure the template directory to avoid accidental changes. Now let's go one step further and keep every version of the report that has been generated. If we look at Anatella flow, we have a similar setup as a previous flow, but we're going to create a new file in the published directory, including the run date in the file name. This way, all historic versions of the flow remain available. To do this, we are going to put the current date in a global variable and update the write Excel box, where instead of writing to a constant file name, we're going to add a bit of JavaScript to the destination part. We just add the greater than symbol to start, and we're going to create a string with a fixed part of the file name and the location. Then we concatenate with a plus sign our global parameter into the file name. Now we have a flow where the template is secured and historic runs are available. For the last step, we are making a variation on this. We are moving the historic versions to a backup folder, avoiding a crowded publish folder. We are going to use the date stamp in the historic versions, but not in the last version, so not in the published directory. This gives the ability to share a fixed link to the report in the organization, which is also quite handy. Again, only small changes are needed to get this flow going. For the write Excel box, we now write to the backup directory instead of the published directory, still including the date stamp in the file name. An extra file copy has been added to copy the last version from the backup directory to the published directory, however, without the date stamp in the file name. Why this detour, you say? Well, there's one risk. If the report is in use while we run the flow, we can't overwrite it, and the copy will fail. But the right version will be in the backup directory. And now, small extra, we can shell this flow directly to run daily like this. Now the report will be ready every day. I hope this video was helpful. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more of these videos, subscribe to the channel. Oh yes, if interested, I will provide the example flows in a zip file so you can look step by step. I will add the link to the description. Ciao!